Good afternoon. Magandang hapon po sa inyo lahat. Pakibati po ang nasa katabi mo. Magandang hapon, kapatid. You can see the excitement sa upan ng bawat isa, knowing that God has restored blessing whenever His people gather together. Praise God. Praise the Lord for our praise and worship team. And I think we are again blessed to have one of our sisters to lead us in our worship this afternoon, the Youth of Israel of FECC. I don't know kung kilala niyo po siya. But really, whenever Sister Carol leads, we are led into the presence of the Lord in our worship. So praise the Lord for her life. Sadali po tayo mo ko, tayo kayo manalangin. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you that we can declare that we belong to you, God. Not because of what we have done, but because of your grace, because of your goodness. And it is in the same reason that we are here right now. And our overflowing joy is a manifestation of your goodness in our lives that compels us again to give you the honor and the glory that you deserve. And we are also grateful, Lord, knowing that whenever we are gathered with this special blessing that you have in store for each one of us, as a family of believers, you called us to come and worship you together with one heart and with one mind. Now, as we continually do that, Father, we ask that you will just speak to us through your word. May you see a willing heart to obey you and to always strive to grow in our relationship with you. We submit to ourselves, our whole being, our mind, our heart, even our bodies, that it may be a living sacrifice to you. So we thank you for this time. Let there be joy as we study your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. One of the Queen of England who's known to be people lover is none other than Queen Mary. Makamasa po siya kilala, and she loves to mingle with people. And there are times that she's going to dress just like an ordinary person and will play with kids. But one time when she played with little kids, suddenly a rainfall, and so she was forced to find a refuge for a while. And she found one, a little house. Nakisilo muna siya doon sa labas, sa balkonahe. And then she knocked on the door, trying to ask whether there's a person that could lend her an umbrella. And fortunately, a guy opened the door, and she was not really recognized as the Queen Mary of England. Lagi yung kanyang dress ay talaga very ordinary, and medyo nakasombrero siya ng isang ordinary sombrero. And so she asked for an umbrella if she could borrow, and she's going to return it. The guy who opened the door was so hesitant, but she can do anything but to look for one, and she find one. Fortunately, it was a broken umbrella, and so she just extended it outside and said, "This is the only umbrella I can lend you." So without saying any word, the queen left. The next day, a guy with a golden braid hair, of course known to be servants in the palace, knocked on the same door. And the same guy who lent the umbrella to the queen opened the door. And he was amazed that a servant from the palace came. And suddenly the guy said, "I came back with this letter giving you thanks for what you have lent our queen yesterday when she took a refuge in your little house. And now she's returning it back to you." And of course the guy was so regretful, saying, "Sayang. I miss the opportunity that I could offer her my best service. Napalagpas niya yung pagkakataon. And I believe no one among us would really feel that we will be the same position. Sana huwag natin mapalagpas yung mga ganun bagay. And it's true, a true servant of the Lord Jesus Christ would ever like to miss a rare opportunity like that. Unfortunately, according to one Gallup survey in the United States of America, it says that only 10% of church members are active in any kind of ministry. Only 10%. So if there's 100, there's only 10 who's very active in moving in the ministry. And 50% of members have no interest at all in serving in any ministry. Wala silang desire na mag-participate at maglingkod. And when asked, what's the reason why they have no interest at all is because they felt that the Lord is not leading them to do so. Para bang hindi sila tinutulak ng Panginoon. Ladies and gentlemen, this month we're starting a new series about pursuing the will of God in serving or in our service. And for this week or Friday, we're going to start this theme, The Reason for Our Christian Service. And let me title this message this afternoon, My Pleasure to Serve You. Can you say to your neighbor, please, My Pleasure to Serve You. Yeah. Ang ibig sabihin niyan, he's giving you or she's giving you the right to wake her up if she's sleeping. Okay? Alright. Our passage is found in Matthew chapter 20, verse 20 to 28. And I'll be requesting you to please stand again in honor of the reading of God's Word. I'll be reading the first, and then you'll respond with the next. Then the mother of Zebedee's sons came to Jesus with her sons, and kneeling down, asked a favor of him. Don't know what you're asking, Jesus said to them. Can you drink the cup I'm going to drink? We can, they answered.
Jesus said to them, you will need
to drink from my cup. When the 10 heard about this, they were indignant with the two brothers. So with you instead, whoever wants to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wants to be first must be your slave. All together? Just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. Praise be to the reading of his word, you may be seated, please. So why do we serve, and what's the reason for our Christian service? Let me give you three things that are foundational for our desire to serve the Lord. First, serving is the purpose of God for our salvation. This is the primary reason why we serve the Lord, because serving is the purpose of God for our salvation. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 to 10, again, a very familiar passage, will tell us, for it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. And verse 10, for we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus, to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. Now, the verse 8 simply tells us that our salvation is based on the grace of God. Ang ating pong kaligtasan ay nakabase sa biyaya ng Diyos. The grace of God, as commonly known to us, is the merited favor of God. It's a favor of God, and it means that salvation is something you receive not by working for it, not by paying for it, not because you deserve it, but only and simply due to the favor of God, so that men may not boast. Malinaw po yung sinasabi niyan. Look at verse 9. Not by works, so that no one can boast. Ang kaligtasan at ang pagpunta sa langit ay dahil sa pabor o biyaya ng Diyos. Hindi mo pwedeng paghirapan, hindi mo matatanggap dahil karapat dapat kang tumanggap, at hindi mo ito masasabing kayang bayaran. Why? It is the grace of God. It is a favor of God. Ito po'y biyaya lamang sa atin ng Diyos. You can't do anything just to earn your salvation. Okay? Now, verse 9 or verse 10 declares why we are saved. And we're going to emphasize this. Pinakita sa atin ang biyaya ng Diyos, ang dahilan kung ba't tayo naligtas, at magiging na ating pananampalataya. But in verse 10, now it will tell us clearly why we are saved by grace. For we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works. Mga kapatid, dito ay marami pong nalilitong mga tao. Ano po? Why? Malinaw dyan. We were created in Christ Jesus, referring still, in our salvation in the Lord Jesus Christ and through the Lord Jesus Christ, and the purpose is for us to serve God. Just to clarify these things, we have to understand that you don't do good things to be saved. You do it as a sign or evidence that you are already saved. Hindi po tayo gumagawa ng mabuti bilang Kristiyano para tayo maging katanggap-tanggap sa Diyos at para tayo ay maligtas at para tayo ay mapunta sa langit. No. No amount of goodness can lead us and enable us to go to heaven. Wala po. Okay? Kaya malino yan. Everything falls short on God. Ibig sabihin, hindi tayo nakakaabot. Kahit anong gawin natin, no amount of goodness of good works. That's why you don't do things that are good to be saved. You do it as a sign or evidence that you are already saved. Magkaiba po yun. Ano po? Ang ibig sabihin, kaya ka gumagawa ng mabuti is because something had already happened to you. You have already received the gift of eternal life and you are already saved. Sabi ho ng isang theologian, very famous, si John Stott, he said, good works are indispensable to salvation. Yeah, medyo controversial yung kanyang unang sinabi. Good works are indispensable, meaning, hindi pwede mawala. Hindi para makamit mo ang kaligtasan, not as its grounds or means, but is it as its consequence and evidence. It is indispensable not as a means. Hindi ibig sabihin, para maligtas ka, kailangan mong gumawa ng mabuti. No, it is an evidence or consequence of your salvation. It implies then that everyone who claims that they are saved will eventually serve and do good things so because it's the purpose of God for their salvation. Ang totoong taong nagsasabing siya'y ligtas na will eventually offer her service to the Lord and to people. Again, this is the very, very foundational statement that we have to remember that we are not saved by serving, but we are saved for serving. Can we read that all together again? Please, ready? Begin. We are not saved by serving, but we are saved for serving. Ito po yung isang gusto kong tandaan namin. Tayo ay naglilingkod hindi para maligtas, tayo ay naglilingkod dahil tayo'y naligtas na. Amen po ba? Malino po yun mga kapatid. It gives you the ability to be rested and be freed from the concern what would happen to me. Yung iba kaya nahihirapan maglingkod is they thought that through their service, God will be pleased and will accept them. The acceptance of God is not dependent on your service, kapatid. The acceptance of God for you is through the Lord Jesus Christ. By grace, through the Lord Jesus Christ. Tinanggap ka ng Panginoon hindi dahil sa'yo, kundi dahil kay Kristo. Without the Lord Jesus Christ, God will never accept you. Amen po ba? Pero yung mga tao na naghihirap, magpapakabuti para matanggap sila ng Diyos na ay ang bigat ng kalagayan. They will always struggle and it will always be a burden because you don't know how much good works you ought to do for you to be accepted by God. Di ba? Ang hirap nun. Kapag ang dahilan para tanggapin ka ng Diyos, yung gumawa ka ng mabuti at maglingkod sa Kanya, the next question is, how much of your service and how much of your good works are necessary for you to be accepted by God? Walang pwede magsabi nun. Pero, naka-formulate ulit ng konsepto ang ibang tao, basta kaya niyang tapatan yung dami ng kasalanan ko, yung dami ng mabuti kong ginagawa. My friend, you cannot even equalize the two. Hindi mo kayang tapatan yung dami ng kasalanan mo sa pamamagitan ng paggawa ng mabuti at paglilingkod sa Diyos. Again, very familiar illustration. Psychologists will tell you that there are not more or less 10,000 thoughts that are coming into our mind in and out. 10,000 in one day, right? More or less. Now the question is, how many of those thoughts are sinful and evil? Yeah. Sabihin na natin. Sabihin na po natin. 10 na lang. 10 na lang. Alright. 10 sinful thoughts out of the 10,000. Can you imagine? That's 1%. Is that right? No. 100. 1,000. 1.1. Tama ba, Kuya Maloy? Sige ka mga kautan. 0.1, I think. 0.001 pa. Di ba? Can you imagine just 10%? O 10 of those thoughts are evil. Now, wala pa po dyan yung sinasabi that even the actions that we're doing, just the thoughts, we seen by the thoughts that are inside our minds. Now, just multiply that with the days of a year. How many days in a year? 365, and then multiply it by 10, that's 3,650. 3,650, and you are going to live your life. Let us say, you're just going to live by 30 years. And you have 3,650 sins, thoughts, sinful thoughts. That would be how many? Wow. 900,000? A million. Because that's 3,000 times 30. You what? Am I right? Okay. So, ibig sabihin, marami pa rin yung kasalanan mo. And that is enough for you to be found guilty by God. That's why you cannot equalize the good works that you, the evil things that you're doing with the good works that you're offering to the Lord. No. Everything falls short on the glory of God. Hindi tayo makakaabot. That's why we need the Lord Jesus Christ, who has no sin, who has to die for us, so that when He is offered, our sins can be forgiven. And He has already did that. And that's why whenever we come to the Lord, we come through the Lord Jesus Christ, because Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Walang tatanggapin ng Diyos na hindi sa pamamagitan ng Panginoon sa Kristo, because it was His Son who paid for our sins. It was His Son who's the only acceptable offering for Him and for our sins. Ladies and gentlemen, let me remind you again that we are saved not by good works, but by grace through the Lord Jesus Christ and trusting Him as our personal Lord and Savior. That's why, in return, we are saved by the Lord to serve Him and to serve other people. Now, let me strengthen this point to you by telling you that in the English word, there is a such thing as word as oxymoron. Oxymoron. Mag-aral lang po tayo sandali. Oxymoron is a combination of words that have opposite or very different meanings according to Merriam-Webster. Ito po ay kombinasyon ng dalawang salita na yung dalawang salita na yun, or phrase maybe, are directly opposite. Directly opposite. Example, bitter, sweet. Meron, mag-isip na ako kayo ng bagay na bitter at sweet. Kaya po yan. And yet, these are being used as words, praise, bitter, sweet. Another. Second best. Meron bang best na second? And yet, we're using that. Di ba? Pero mabalik natin. Another word. Doing nothing. Dapat, are you doing something? Pero these words are being used. You're doing nothing. How can you do nothing? Parang hirap isipin. Meron pa nga ako, I've not written it down, the word authentic replica. Diba? Pag bumili kayo, authentic replica, class A, authentic replica. Ano naging authentic yung replica? But it's becoming acceptable right now kapag ginagamit po natin. Ang tawag po dyan ay mga salita oxymorons. Diba? Mahirap tanggapin. But also, sa Christian world, meron din po. Meron tayong tinatawag na uncommitted Christian. Can you be a Christian and yet uncommitted? This is an oxymoron, mga kapatid. You can't be a Christian and yet not be committed to the Lord Jesus Christ. No? And yet, balasak na palaksak kaya salita na yan. Uncommitted Christians. Non-serving Christians. Mga kapatid, if you understand being a Christian, you cannot be a Christian and yet not serving at all. Hindi po. I'll explain it to you. Alright? You cannot say that you love God and yet you don't extend help to your neighbor. Why? Malinaw kasi utos ng Panginoon. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. Those who say that they love God and they hate their brothers are liars. Sabi ng Bible. Sinungaling. Hindi pwede. At hindi pwede magkatotoo na mahal mo ang Diyos pero hindi mo mahal ang kapwa mo. Hindi totoo yan. Diba? Pero, again, sometimes it's easy for us to consider that these are true. That there's such thing as uncommitted Christians. Diba? Kaya minsan pinagtatalunan ang tatawag natin sa mga members. Committed members? Uncommitted members? Ang mahirap yata pong samahin yung mga kapatid. Alright? Why? Because let's remember Matthew chapter 7 verse 20 to 21. Yes, this is in Living Bible. Okay, this is a good translation that I pick out to clarify this term. Yes, the way to identify a tree or a person is by the kind of food produced. Totoo ba mga kapatid? Yung isang puno ng mangga, pwede ba mamunga ng bayabas? Simple. Di ba? Malalaman mo yung puno kadalasan sa pamagitan ng bunga. Malinaw sinasabi. The way to identify a tree or a person is by the kind of fruit it produced. Tignan mo yung bunga, makikita mo, masasabi mo kung ano yung puno. You know the context of that? Verse 21. Not all who sound religious are really godly people. They may refer to me as Lord, but still won't get to heaven. For the decisive question is whether they obey my Father in heaven. Now, sa ibang translation niya, yung Bible niya tayo, not all who say to me, Lord, 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 will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only those who does the will of my Father in heaven. Ano sinasabi niya mga kapatid? Sometimes there are narami mga tao na they look religious. They sound religious. But that's not the bottom line when it comes to our standing before the Lord. Sabi dyan, for the decisive question is whether they obey my Father in heaven. They do the will of God. Ang ibig ba sabihin yan, Pastor, ibig sabihin pala talaga, ang daan sa langit ay ang pagsunod sa Diyos. Hindi po, mga kapatid. Sapagkat ang tao na may kakayanan lang sumunod sa Diyos, kinakailangan ng bagong puso. Wala kang kakayanan sumunod sa Diyos and be acceptable to God unless your heart is changed. maliban na yung puso mo mabago. Because man is corrupt, the tendency is always to be evil and to be wicked and to be sinful. There must be a change. That's why maraming tao, tingnan nyo, kung daan sa langit ay pagsunod talaga. I would like to clarify this phrase to you, or these words and this verse to you. Kung daan sa pagpunta sa langit ay pagsunod, mga kapatid. Ang ibig sabihin, mas maraming tao na mas madali at makapasok sa langit, lalo na yung nagsasakripisyo ng alam mga sarili para sa Diyos. Yung mga nagpapapako, yung mga lumalakad ng panahon. Is that true? No. Because we have to understand that obedience is a byproduct of our faith in God. Kailangan mo munang pagtiwalaan ng Diyos, isuko mo yung sarili sa Kanya, and then a change heart that would happen in your within will definitely change the direction of your life. That now your tendency is to obey the will of God. Without the change, it will be very difficult for you to do the will of God and to obey Him. Anong katotohanan niyo, Pastor? Sabi ni Pablo, the things I want to do, I cannot do. The things I do not want to do, I do. Sabi niya, wretched I am, who will save me? But praise be to God through the Lord Jesus Christ. Si Pablo daw nagsabi niyo, ang mga bagay na gusto kong gawin, hindi ko magawa. Ang mga bagay na ayaw kong gawin, siya kong ginagawa. Why? Because of the heart that is within us, that is inclined to do evil, hindi po natin kayang gumawa ng mabuti. Pastor, ibig sabihin wala tayong nagagawa ng mabuti. Meron, pero hindi papasa sa Diyos. Kaya na sinabi sa Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. People are attempting, but they are falling, and they cannot reach that level that is acceptable before the Lord. Kaya naman mga kapatid, just to go deeper on this, hindi yung ibig sabihin that we are not going to be, in fact, the byproduct of our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ is obedience to Him. Ang totoong nananampalataya sa Diyos ay lumalakad na may pagsunod sa Kanya. Amen po ba? Hindi na mahirap na yung sumunod. Dati wala kang kakayanan, laging gusto mong gawin. Hindi naman nangyayari. But this time, because you surrendered your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, now you have the capacity to obey God and His words. Again, it is a true-to-life experience even to me. I came to know the Lord Jesus Christ, isang batang basagulero, a bully, and everything in our community, lumakipo ko sa mundo, palaway ako. Pero when I came to know the Lord Jesus Christ, suddenly, wala naman nagsabi sa akin magbago ko. But something happened, and everything was changed. Those flowering words, the attitudes, everything has changed. Now, there is an inclination to obey God and His Word. Why? Because a change happened within when the Lord Jesus Christ take control of my life. Ganun din po tayo mga kapatid. Kinakailangan tayo munang baguhin ang Panginoon bago tayo totoong makasunod ng lubusan sa Kanya. And only people who trusted the Lord Jesus Christ has the capacity to indeed obey the Father in heaven. That's why it's inevitable that a person who trusts the Lord Jesus Christ will also do His will and follow His will. Now, totoo bang naranasan ng mga tao yan? Look at those people who encountered the Lord Jesus Christ. Look at Matthew, a tax collector. Iniiwasan ng mga tao sa sanlibutan, sa community niya. Why? Of course, a tax collector noon in the time, sobrang mangikin. Pinahirapan yung mga tao. But Matthew had already something happening in his life. So he was so excited when he heard about the Lord Jesus Christ. He went up to the tree to look who's this Jesus Christ. And suddenly Jesus took notice of him. Matthew, go down and today I will go and visit you in your house. Excited si Matthew. Mga kapatid, imagine binigyan siya ng pansin ng Diyos. Eh, kinilisan siya ng mga tao sa paligid. ang nagbigay ng pansin sa kanya talaga sa kanya ang Panginoon Jesucristo pa. And so when Jesus visited him in his house, Matthew, as a manifestation that there was already happened in his life, sabi niya, from now on, kung may niloko man ako, at totoo naman meron siya, ibabalik ko 4 times of what I have robbed them. Can you imagine? 4 beses pa nung dinakaw ko sa kanila, isosoli ko. A complete change. Dati gusto niya magnakaw na magnakaw, ngayon, ibinabalik niya. Yung babaeng maraming asawa, mga kapatid. Nagbisita ng Panginoon sa Kristo, the Samaritan woman. Sabi sa kanya, Lord, tawagin mo asawa mo. Wala po akong asawa, tama yan. Kasi yung kinakasama ko ngayon, hindi mo asawa. Nakakalima na siya. Pero suddenly, when this woman encountered the Lord Jesus Christ, there was a sudden change. Nabago siya. And of course, we'll miss the Apostle Paul. The Paul, the murderer, the exterminator, and yet when he encountered the Lord Jesus Christ, he was changed. Mga kapatid, ang totoong merong relasyon kay Kristo at ligtas na ay merong pagbabago sa buhay. Amen po ba? Pag-isabi sa katabi mo, ikaw yun, kapatid. Ikaw yun. Pero tanong mo rin, may nagbago na ba talaga, kapatid? May nagbago na ba? Hindi pwedeng sabihin natin, claim natin ang claim, we are born again. Pwedeng title lang yan. Pero wala dyan ang basehan. He is always in a transformed life. Wala rin sa dami ng alam yan. Wala sa galing yan. No, it's always in a transformed life. You will know whether a person has really trusted the Lord Jesus Christ kapag meron ang nagbabago sa buhay niya. You shall know them by their fruits. Tignan mo yung bunga. Hindi pwede. Hindi pwede mabunga ng mangga yung bayabas at yung bayabas ng mangga. Hindi pwede. Oxymoron yan. Baliktad. Hindi pwede. That's why those people who claim that they're born again Christians will definitely manifest a fruit, a changed life. Because people who encounter the Lord Jesus Christ, hindi pwede hindi magbago. Hindi pwede. And I believe if you trusted the Lord Jesus Christ in your life, mga kapatid, meron ng bago dyan. Pwedeng paunti-unti, pero hindi pa pwedeng walang pagbabago. Amen po ba?
Yeah.
Meron yan. Eh yung iba naman, mukhang di pa Kristiyano yan. Kasi wala pang ano eh. Don't be hasty in giving judgment. It is just for us to discern, not to judge. Amen po ba? Mag-ingat po tayo. We just need to discern, but not to judge. Because you'll be here later on, you may realize, ay, napaagay yata yung sinasabi ko. Because meron pala katutubalang anak ng Diyos. Okay? Not all who serve are saved. But you can't say that you are saved and yet you are not serving. Hindi po lahat ng naglilingkod sa Diyos ay ligtas. Pero hindi mo pwedeng sabihin ligtas ka na at hindi ka naglilingkod. You can't help to serve God if Christ is in your life. Whether you like it or not, merong mag-uudyok sa iyo at magsasabing, you need to serve and reach out to other people. Amen po ba? Hindi pa pwede. Kasi nandyan ang banal na Espiritu. Perhaps, sabi nga na isang writer, perhaps when we face our Maker, we will not be asked how many positions did you hold, but rather, how many people did you help? Gano'ng karami na yung taong tinulungan mo at pinaglingkuran mo? Because service is a manifestation of your salvation. Again, to elaborate on this point, Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11, 12, and 16 says, it was He who gave some to be apostles, some to be prophets, some to be evangelists, and some to be pastors and teachers, to prepare God's people for works of service, so that the body of Christ may be built up, and from Him the whole body joined and held together by supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love as each part does the work. Mga kapatid, bakit ko binabasa yan? This passage tells us that each one who received and surrendered their lives to the Lord Jesus Christ, again, are people who are enabled and incapacitated, sabihin natin, are capable of serving the Lord. Binigyan tayo ng kakayanan na maglingkod sa Panginoon. Why? Because you have a part in the body of Christ. Meron po kayong bahagi sa katawan ni Kristo. Now, to illustrate and clarify this, today, or yeah, this week, it was already released, that many of us are aware, it was already released that the new iPhone 7 is out. Di ba? Meron ako pong bumili sa inyo? Wala pa, masyado pang mahal. How many of you are waiting for another model next year? Okay? Sabi po ng ating mga kalakihan, you have to wait for another phone that is coming out that is very, very versatile. Okay? Gillette is releasing its new cell phone. Yes? Yung cell phone na pwede kang tumatawag habang nagkakahit na. Do you think it's convenient and it's good to see a cell phone na ginagamit mo habang nag-aaral ka? Will it be convenient for you? No. Ang hirap yata nun. Biro mo. Pag nasa ibaba na. Will there be a cell phone that is good for brushing your hair? Parang awkward, hindi ko ba? Now, mga kapatid, I'm just using that as an illustration. If you want to live according to the purpose or design by God, that will be inconvenient too for your life and for others. Kapag ang buhay mo ay ginugugol, hindi para sa layunin ng Diyos, you will experience inconveniences. That will be uncomfortable. In fact, many, many times, it will be a burden and not a blessing. You will not be contented in what you're doing. Hindi ka magiging lubos na masaya. Kasi hindi ka nagagamit doon sa lugar na dapat kang gamitin. Hindi doon sa design na sa'yo ng Diyos. Ganun din po yung mga kapatid. Ang buhay natin will only find its satisfaction if we are being utilized according to our purpose. Anong purpose ng Diyos sa atin? We are saved to serve. Para maglingkod sa Kanya. That's why, if your life is being spent not in serving God, you will at times feel something uneasiness, inconveniences in your life. Kasi ang totoong ligtas at may relasyon kay Kristo will never be contented with his life that is not being used for God. Amen po ba? Pakitignan ko yung katabi muli. Pakitignan kung gising pa. Kapatid, you are designed to serve. If you have the Lord Jesus Christ in your life, you are designed to serve. Okay? However, unfortunately, meron nagsabi, some people are like canoes. Yung kaya. They have to be paddled. Some people are like kite. If you don't keep them on a string, they fly away. Some people are like football. You can't tell which way they'll bounce next time. Some people are like balloon, full of wind and ready to go up. Some people are like trainer. They have to be pulled in order to act. But some people are like watch. Open face, pure good, quite busy, and full of good works. So what are you, my friend? Sana kayo ay totoong ginto, porsan, orilo. Do you need to be pulled or to be pushed? Just to serve the Lord? I don't know, sabi ng isang lalaki, I don't know what your destiny will be, but one thing I know, the only ones among you will be really happy are those who have sought and found how to serve. Ang totoong masaya sa buhay, yung naglilingkod para sa iba at para sa Diyos. Amen po ba? Because those people are selfish. They're not concerned about themselves, but they're concerned for others and for God. Pakisabi po niya sa katabi ko, na may ngiti naman, kapatid, you are saved to serve. You are saved to serve. Okay? You are saved to serve. Now the second reason why we have to serve and we are serving is that serving is the path to greatness of a servant. It is the path to greatness of a servant. Ang paglilingkod ay daan sa kadakilaan ng isang tagapaglingkod. Let me ask you, sino po sa akin dito gusto maging dakila? Who among you wants to be great? Meron po ba? Mahirap na tanong yun sa mga Pilipino kasi likas na po tayong mahiyain. Diba? Biking rin sa ako po. Pero pag mga Amerikano tinanong mo, yes. Walang matitira. Pero pag tinanong mo naman, sino sa inyo gusto maging walang kwenta? Of course, ayaw natin maging walang kwenta. Pero, alam niyo ba na, it is the innate desire of man to be known, to be recognized, and to be great. Desire mo talaga ng tao yan. It's a natural thing. His desire to be great and to be recognized. Kaya na maraming tao kulang sa pansin. KSP. Pakitanong mo sa katabuhi ka ba yun? Pati. Yes. Look at the Guinness World of Records, mga kapatid, matatawa ka. Iba-ibang uri ng tao, iba-ibang uri ng kakayanan, para lang makilala sila. Ano po yan? O ito, pinakamalaki at malawak na bibig. Okay? Kasya yung isang Coca-Cola pag pinasok mo ng patagilin. Nasa Guinness World of Records yan, mga kapatid. He's the guy who can really insert a full can sa kanyang bibig. Ganong kalapad yung kanyang bibig, mga kapatid. Okay? Another guy, ito. Yung tao na kaya mag-pop up ng kanyang ng eyeball. Pinaka-farthest. Okay? Na-recognize po ng Guinness World of Record yan. Yan, ito yung tao na who can stretch his skin. Can you imagine? O yan. So pwede niyang pag-stretch ng skin, pati yung kanyang chan, pwede niya kong ilandat at gawing, ano tawag ito? Train. Nang inumin. O, kasi, wait kami yata siya sa isang bat. Can you imagine yung mga ganitong uri ng kakailan? Alright? But these are in the Guinness World of Records. Why? Because it is the inner desire of man to be recognized. Kaya kahit ano na lang, basta makilala ka, mapansin ka, gagawin ng tao. Ganun po ang tao, mga kapatid. Now, is it okay to strive to be great? Yes. In fact, God wants us to be great. We are just ordinary people, but God wants us to be extraordinary people. But we have to do it in His way. Hindi sa paraan ng mundo, kundi sa paraan ng Diyos, mga kapatid. Why? Let's go to that passage that we read. Remember the passage that we read when I'm starting? The story speaks about the Lord Jesus Christ about to be betrayed and crucified. Okay? And then suddenly, the mother, Mary, came and asking, Lord, pwede ba yung anak ko sa kaliwa at sa kanan mo? Can you imagine mamamatay ng Panginoon Kristo, ang iniisip ng magulang, eh mapwesto yung kanyang mga anak malapit sa Panginoon Kristo. Kasi posisyon ng kapangyarihan niya, mga kapatid. Yun pa ang laman ng isip niya. And so napansin mo alagad. Galit sila doon sa mga kapatid nila alagad. Yung sampu, napansin nila. Galit sila sa dalawa kasi ginamit pa yung nanay nila para lang mag-ask ng pesto sa Panginoon Kristo. But it's natural desire of the parents also to make their children great. Di ba? Naniniwala ko ba kayo? Kaya nga di ba, pag medyo nakakuha ng mataas na grade yung anak natin sa school, o kaya honor, anong ginagawa natin? Apost yan sa Facebook. Congratulations! Proud na proud yan. Nag-aaguan pa yung mag-asawa, kamukha ko talaga anak. Because wala namang magulang na ayaw na umasenso yung kanya anak. We always want our children to be known, to be great, and to be successful. But again, God wants us to be great in His own way. In what way? Sabi niya sa verse 26, whoever wants to become great among you must be your servant. And whoever wants to be first must be your slave. Mga kapatid, ang katotohanan nito, may paraan para maging sikat ka at maging dakila. Anong paraan ng Panginoon? Maglingkod ka sa marami. Sir, you want to be superstar? Be a servant. Be a servant. Because that is God's way of being up there and being a great person. Wala akong ibang paraan ng Panginoon para maging dakila ka, kundi ang maglingkod. And Jesus manifested that and showed that to us, that the road to greatness and the path to greatness is by serving other people and God. You want to be great, Father? Gusto mo maging dakila ka, Ma? Pag-uwi mo ng bahay, anong trabaho ng tatay? You ought to be a leader, you ought to be a protector, you ought to be a provider. So pag-uwi mo ng bahay, huwag ka muna maghanap ng kahit na ano. Ano ba itong gulo-gulo? Pag-uwi mo, ito asawa ko, amoy ulam. Eh paano din magiging amoy ulam? Have you provided, nagbigay ka pang pambili na sabon? Baka pati pambili na sabon, hindi mo mabilan, kaya ulam ulam.